course, on the internet for terrible things, read with enthusiasm. In the room tonight, we have Boots Rain Gear.
I have been spitting up gray matter from my lungs for a while now, and I am concerned. What could this be?
Your brains, apparently. Jimmy Franks!
What to do when a cat eats meth?
Isfahan!
Do insects see us as gods?
Frank West!
What is your favorite age?
And Lemon. What is wrong with Bobby Fischer?
Castle and Kingside? Come on.
Hey, Lemon.
Hi, Lemon.
Hello.
How is it going? Are you doing well?
Doing great.
Great. Hey, what are your opinions on religion and sex and politics and relationships and dogs and the internet?
My opinions are authoritative and popular.
I'm against all of those things.
I want more or less.
Montrith recently stumbled across a site that I'm surprised we hadn't heard of until now. It's called blurnit.com. Actually, you know what? Let's come up with a definitive pronunciation of this for the episode. It's called blurnit.com.
Blurnit.
And Blurnit is a place, and this is really what's innovative about Blurnit, is that somebody just randomly types a stupid question onto the internet, and other people type back responses. Oh,
I haven't heard of any site like that
nice
before.
Nice, fresh new format for us here.
So let's just start out here. Jimmy Franks, you are Stephen Vakula. And you're just going to blurt your first blurt.
Stephen Vakula.
Is girlfriend-boyfriend culture good or not? The whole concept and press on the importance of sex is a bad message. I talk with my daughters about this and tell them that when you're young, and especially given the TV shows and media concentration and focus on sex, it is unrealistic in life.
That's true. People don't have sex in real life.
Yep.
Total time in my total life that I've spent engaged in sex compared to everything else, if you really think about it, is grossly overstated.
Not getting much, are you?
I think that means he's constantly having sex, if I'm reading that
correctly.
He's
constantly talking about it, but it doesn't really...
Yeah, he's just constantly talking about the fact he has sex.
And as we all know, the time you spend doing something is directly proportional to how important and pivotal it is in your life.
It's true!
Getting stuck in traffic is the most important thing to talk to your kids about.
Rapid eye movement! A topic of conversation!
Sex is great. Don't get me wrong.
Good.
But this major focus on having sex is the issue that is unrealistic. Sex with someone that means something to you is much better than sex with just a person.
Right.
Okay. For one, the STDs... Sorry?
Is he saying he's not having sex with people?
For one, the STDs of today are not the forgiving or controllable types they were in the past.
Sure.
Those STDs became bastards.
They don't make them like these.
I miss when syphilis was lethal.
Yeah.
The permanent diseases and consequence dictate that sex be with not only someone that you have feelings in a relationship with, but also that is healthy and safe.
Okay.
MTV, when it came out, was about music.
Oh, good. Yay. Now your post is about this.
Yeah.
Today it doesn't even play music except as a soundtrack for the Let's Have Sex show it airs.
I need to go back to MTV.
Yeah. Call your cable. Wait,
does MTV actually broadcast Sex House now?
God, I hope so.
I tell my girls to just have fun. There's no rush, nor should there ever be a rush to have sex.
Let's have fun is a euphemism for fucking.
Yeah.
They will have sex and enough of it and should think of sex as giving something of themselves that they can never get back, and they get that much from the person that they have sex with in
that
return.
That is what they should think about it as, yeah.
And telling them that will not fuck them up, will save them from getting fucked up.
Thanks, Dad. So they had better be careful, as someone may look cool today and gone tomorrow.
as someone may look cool to...
Wait, if they're going to die tomorrow, you should probably have sex with them now, really.
Fuck now.
My name's Chris!
I can't believe it.
Anyway, I'm Chris! Your verbose and well-thought-out answer deserves a wow!
Thank you.
But I personally feel that it is not good to allow your girls to watch MTV.
I don't see where I wrote I let them watch MTV. I use MTV as a reference, not as a statement that I let them watch it.
Oh. It was kind of hard to keep the thread of what you were talking about with you suddenly breaking into an old man rant at the end there.
These kids with their baggy pants and their pagers.
All right, Boots, you have a more serious, important question about relationships and sex. You're anonymous.
Okay. How can I find out whether a girl is virgin or not?
That's the end of your question. Mm-hmm. All done.
Yep.
In and out.
Done. Wait, in and out? Is that how I tell?
In and out is one way to find out.
Mm-hmm. Isfahan, you are also anonymous.
Yes.
Here's a test a doctor can perform on a guy or a girl to tell whether or not they have had sex or not. Just ask your doctor.
Make sure it's a doctor that's constantly wringing his hands.
Ask your doctor about whether or not they have had sex or not.
Ask your doctor about boy hymen.
Frank West, you are Beth Jones.
You can find out if she is a virgin by either taking her to the doctor or using your finger. She would still bleed no matter what age if she was a virgin.
What?
But sometimes a girl doesn't bleed during the first time.
Huh?
Even if she masturbates, she would still bleed. Hope I could help.
Nope. You couldn't.
That is extremely dangerous, Beth, assuming that this person knows what you mean by bleeding.
Using a... Yeah, she doesn't say what to do with the finger.
Yeah.
Right.
If you jam it in her eye, she'll still bleed.
That's an accusatory finger. Are you a virgin?
Oh, I see. If you ask her if she's a virgin and you point an accusatory finger and she starts bleeding, like, from her mouth or nose or something, that's...
Yeah. I'm also anonymous. Yes, she may still bleep. But it depends if it has been broen, though other thing, like sports. There are a number of reasons why she may not bleed.
Resins.
There are a number of resins why she may not bleed, but this doesn't mean she isn't a virgin, and no other way. But if you thin that she is not, the doctor can she. But if she is, then she may bleed when you have sex. Boots, you're also anonymous.
Make a huge scene about it one night. Start breaking stuff. If she still denies it, break something bigger to get your point across. If she continues to deny it, tell her to prove it. It works every time. Trust me, little buddy.
Skipper!
But I do that every night.
She's sitting there at the dining room table. She's smashing dishes, and she's thinking to herself, I'm not going to tell him until he breaks the microwave. I'll know he's serious if he breaks the microwave.
Jimmy Franks, you are Geraldine Chrysanthemum.
If you grow up with old ladies, what? You might know when to distinguish between them.
What?
What?
But sometimes girls lie about it.
Like distinguish between old ladies and virgins?
Mm-hmm. No. Distinguish between different old ladies. Like,
okay.
That one's Gertrude. That one's Martha.
So the only way to know is to study your species. What? The way she carries herself is important. Virgins have a way of walking. Her legs are close to each other when she walks, but if she's not, you'll see a great deal of space with her walking.
So you can tell by the way she walks.
Huh. I'm going to fuck your legs apart.
Can I do the next one?
Yeah, by all means.
Okay, this is anonymous.
Yep.
Lol. Oh, sweaty. Girls have this little thing called a cherry, and if they are virgins, it will be there. And if there is no cherry, she is not a virgin. You will know, sweetheart. You will know.
That second you will know is a little foreboding.
You will know.
So this person actually thinks, like, there is some kind of cherry.
Yeah, just like a maraschino cherry. Just kind of.
There is a literal cherry.
Like in Pac-Man.
That's where we get the phrase, a cherry on top.
Frank West doesn't know where a vagina is.
Boots, you have another very short question, but it's an important one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Why do people get married when it's so pointless?
Frank West, you are Jay Kelly. Jay Chelly, we need a boot.
Jay Chelly. I see where you're coming from. It's like why I have to marry you to prove my love to you. Then, like, if your husband wife cheat on you or do something, you have to pay all that money to get a divorce. Why not stay boyfriend-girlfriend or sugar mama, sugar daddy? And if they mess up, you can just let them go and move on with no problems, lol. That's how I'm looking at it.
Lol.
But I do want a wedding. It's just a traditional thing to do, I guess.
Getting married is stupid, but I do want to get married.
Is there any way I can do a wedding without the marriage stuff?
I think we already did an episode on that.
Isfahan, you also have a very important question. This is in the philosophy section of Blur.
Yeah. Is there such a thing as a wizard?
Blurt it!
Blurt it.
My name's Anonymous. I really believe there's a wizard out there. It's like just unicorns. One. People think they do not exist anymore. But they do. But they do in a far-off land.
Yeah,
you
right.
might think I'm crazy, but every storm you see comes from me.
Anonymous? Oh, yes.
Is that a threat?
Every fire you see comes from my friend. Every snowflake you see comes from my other friend.
Oh.
Without us, you would have nothing but the moon and stars, which have no fire anywhere, no fire in the stars.
Yeah,
no,
yeah, that's what I say. If without those, we would have nothing
and
but
there's
the moon
no,
and stars.
There's no ice in space either, so.
Mm-hmm. No.
We work our lives to let people know there are wizards in the world. We found a magic vine in our yard. When I am mad, clouds move in. When my friends are happy, it snows or heats up. The point is, believe in wizards and let magic belong to the world once again.
Are you Charlie Brown?
Oh.
When people have feelings, weather happens.
Wow. One of our friends only gets happy in the like for like a quarter of the year.
Frank West, you are the final anonymous on this page.
Wow. Way to impersonate God, sacrilegious freak.
Sacrilegious freak.
Isfahan, can you be the second last anonymous in this?
Okay.
DJ Sacrilegious.
I believe it, but I don't understand. I can't fing that power.
Jimmy Franks, what would you rather talk about, weirdos or emos?
Weirdos.
Weirdos. All right, terrific.
Always.
Hey, Jimmy Franks, what's your definition of a weirdo? You're Alex Krykek.
Well, someone who talks or dresses in an unusual style and makes no attempt to conform. A loner maybe with little or no social skills who is awkward around people. Stalkers would be weird, too, as they think it's okay to behave like that when it's actually really creepy.
It's fine. You're Maddie.
Is it normal to write down people's classes, phone number, and occasionally the address of their house and memorize what car they drive?
You need to go to Is It Normal for that.
But, yeah.
I can't answer that here.
I'm not sure how Maddie picked up, like, that's the thread of conversation we're having.
Yeah.
Is it, like, classes, as in, like upper class?
As long as we're on the subject of stalking.
Working class.
Yeah.
Untouchable. Boots, I want you to be Max Atwood, the most likable person in the world.
Please be Max Atwood.
Okay.
Oh, I love you, Max Atwood.
I'm definitely a weirdo.
Okay.
I'm a lolly-loving bisexual anime otaku.
Go to jail!
I get rejected by two genders.
And that is just the tip of the iceberg. I'm 19 and have an imaginary friend. I dropped out of high school at 18 in the 10th grade, and I fantasy roleplay on Facebook.
Jesus Christ.
So you, basically anyone like me. Anyone like me?
Nope. All right, well, Jimmy Franks wanted to talk about weirdos, so Isfahan, you're going to be talking about emos.
Hey, I accidentally dyed my hair black. Should I come out to my parents about being emo?
Well, I guess I gotta be emo now. My hair's dyed black.
Yeah, lifestyle change.
How do you accidentally...
That's the first question.
Well, you know, it just gets filthier and filthier and filthier.
Lol, how did you accidentally dye it? What color were you going for? Anyway, yeah, I don't think there is anything to be ashamed of for being emo. There were two emo girls in the same grade as me, and everyone liked them because of their personality and how they were unique. So you should be proud. Actually, one of them was kind of hated because she turned into a skank and started seeing other girls' ex-boyfriends and bragging about it. That's not an emo thing, though, is it? You know that sentence earlier where I said they were liked? Well, one of them wasn't, so... But... I don't backspace, because that's lame.
The only thing I hate more than skanks is gossips. Frank West, you are Sarah Thompson?
Come out as Eom? You mean you're actually gay? Most
Elmos... get through it.
Get the word.
Yep. Most Elmos are but off.
Kiss, kiss!
So this person has meant to type emo... twice now, and they've misspelled it both times.
Yeah. Most Elmos.
Most Elmos are but also liking to wear black, or certain frilly things doesn't make you Eom, it's a style.
That's three.
Elmo stands for a
got it.
And not a group you want to join the ranks off. Because this whole following is for people who are depressed for no reason, cutting their wrist for attention and act slummy and mopey all the time. Because it thinks to make them cool and different.
Well, they only have a reason, so I'm confused.
Guess what? It doesn't.
Oh.
Yeah. Take that, emos.
Damn it.
Eoms. Elmos.
Yeah, and Elmos.
Take that, Elmos. Make teenagers who have everything and are spoiled brats seem like they don't appreciate all the gifts they have been given.
Okay.
If you like black, cool, shiny, silly, frilly emo jewelry, which makes you look dumb but cool, your style, but Eom is not like being born gay.
What the fuck?
You get to choose whether or not you want to enjoy your life to the fullest, or be another cowardly teenager that cries for no reason and just wants attention.
Wow, God. Sarah Thompson.
Loves you.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Hey, Boots, what did you just find?
I found a real quick one that Sarah Thompson had upvoted.
Oh, okay, yeah. So, Sarah Thompson, maybe this is me anyway. Hey, did SEAL Team 6 get the bounty for killing Bin Laden?
No. And most of all, Team 6 are long gone now, too, taking a lot of secrets down with them thanks to President Obama.
Holy shit! Oh my god.
Now that Obama had them killed, someone's going to have Obama killed to keep the secret.
I'm kumquatting through the wars and conflicts thing now.
Yeah, I imagine. Yeah.
Kumquatting.
Kumquatting. It's a verb. Kumpotting.
Kumpotting.
Here's one. Here's one asked February 28, 2014. Why is there still war in the 20th century? Aren't people afraid of dying in wars?
Someone should just tell these guys.
Hey, you could die, buddy.
Get it together, child soldiers.
I am
out
of here.
It's the 20th century.
Excuse me, did you know it's the 20th century and war is now lethal?
Jimmy Franks, what do you do if you like a guy, but you know he doesn't like you, so do you tell him and he will realize he likes you too, or wait and let him be your secret crush? Help!
You've covered a lot of ground in your question, but I'm going to try to address your points.
Thank you so much.
All right. Okay, first off, I'm an expert on this type of stuff.
Oh, thank God.
My sis was in the same boat. Now she's been with her man 9 years. Okay, flirt with him, but don't make yourself come off as easy. Every now and then, avoid him. Make him chase you. Guys love that, trust me.
Yeah,
give it a few days.
The best.
Mm-hmm.
Dress very cute, make him pay attention to you. Ask him for help on stuff, even if you know you can do it. Okay, but also flirt. but not to muck and member not come off as eased. Guys hate that, but don't try so hard. Let nature take its course, and if there's something there, trust me, it will bloom.
Great. Well, good said, job, Anonymous.
See, don't...
Guy, you know, he doesn't like you, so that's not going to work.
Yeah, we shouldn't give Anonymous a hard time. He's been living on a boat with his sister and her husband for 9 years.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's fucking beautiful, terrific advice, because men hate sex, they like pains in the ass, and working too hard for something that's not worth it. Boots, you're also anonymous.
Boy, am I. Mm-hmm. You find out how he feels about you through a friend. If he showed interest, you approach him and talk to him, but take it slow. Don't just blurt out, which...
Yep. Yeah,
don't just blurt out he's the greatest thing since peanut butter. Ask him to a soda. might as well go to a soda.
1955. Want to go down to the sock hop and soda fountain?
Yeah.
Okay, but no parking.
Ask him to a soda or something, and go from there. If he showed no interest, don't secretly worship him. Let him go and move on.
Oh, right.
If you want something you can't have, you might not see what you're missing out on.
Wow. Into the quote book with you. I like this guy named Chris, and we are in middle school, but he doesn't like me, so what do? I like to talk to him about hanging out with me. That's my primary topic of conversation. I hang out with him, and then we talk about hanging out. Anyway, a couple friends, and when you do that, wait so he can answer. This is advice, apparently. And don't bug him, but make sure you look and dress real pretty and act girly and be yourself, and then make eye contact with him and flirt with him a little, and you should be fine. Good luck. God get him, and he deserves someone like us girls. Yeah! Dig Lao Chow!
Gog, get him.
Total period count for that post, 0.
Frank West, you are the final anonymous on this page.
Dress better than you do now.
Yeah!
Don some makeup and dresses. Do you hair.
Clean yourself up a bit. No, Jesus.
Zach, I gotta do an alternate reading of that one.
Oh, yeah. All right. Put on some makeup and dresses. Do you hear?
Dress better than you do now. Put on some makeup and dresses and do your hair.
And just like you might also like the recommended ones are all the same one. I like this guy, but how do I find out if he likes me?
There's sometimes I just get too many tabs open at the same time and have to choose
one.
Yeah,
our cup runneth over here.
Yeah. Okay, Jimmy Franks.
Yes?
How to make a homemade tattoo gun out of an electric razor? God. I'm asking how, not why.
Can I make one out of a straight razor?
Do you want the instructions?
Ideally, the first step should be dial 911 and then proceed. When the ambulance arrives, you can stop.
How to get herpes?
I'm Robin Burden, and I'm glad you asked. Making a tattoo gun out of a pair of hair clippers is possible. In fact, it's a common method used by prison inmates to tattoo each other.
Mm-hmm.
As a warning, though, these prison tattoos tend to look pretty bad. So I'm guessing the improvised devices that prison tattooists use may have something to do with that.
By the way, they absolutely give inmates hair clippers.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's just part of your standard issue.
Before I go any further with the whole hair clipper idea, I'd really recommend you take a second to consider purchasing a proper tattoo gun instead.
Because there's no way you could fuck that up.
No thanks.
Yeah, a tattoo is for life. Unless you're prepared to go through months of painful and expensive laser treatment. So I'd recommend making sure the gun you use is of a reliable quality. Now, if you're looking to get a tattoo on the cheap, even buying something like the 15-1 tattoo would be better than making your own gun.
I just wanted to just briefly, the sort of the recommended tattoo on the cheap here is a tattoo gun available from tmart.com. That's tmart.com for the low, low price of $57.99 for everything you need, including they give you rubber gloves mm-hmm. and disposable razors. So,
oh, yeah. But you know, it's like a soda stream. It pays for itself after the first couple.
Yeah. Like if you want the quickest way to a lawsuit, tmart.com, get your own tattoo machine.
Making your own tattoo gun, if I haven't managed to discourage you yet.
Yeah.
Then here's one method of turning a pair of hair clippers into a buzzing tattoo gun. Secure a 12-gauge guitar string onto one side of the clipper's blade. Attach an empty ink tube from a Biro pen to the edge of the clipper opposite the guitar string. You may want to use super glue. Make sure the ink tube is protruding above the blade level.
Mm-hmm.
Thread the other end of the guitar string through the ink tube.
Okay.
Cut this end of the guitar string in a way that leaves a really sharp tip. When you turn the clipper on, the string should bob in and out of the ink tube. Dip the sharp tip in a pot of ink and happy tattooing.
There's no way this person will get farther than maybe, like, a tenth of a second in.
Ow! Wait a minute! What the
Holy
hell?
Holy shit!
I didn't write about that!
They go around the next day, hey, check out my tattoo, it's a dot.
You'll know it's working right when it's playing Dick Dale and the Deltones.
Well,
if you don't have one, like... I have one.
Oh, well, okay, yeah, go ahead. Great, go ahead, do it.
Yeah, what's the grossest thing a couple have done in front of you, and where?
All right.
Keith Old.
Keith Old. All right, go.
Good day, Penny. Thank you for your question. Nothing too gross as I recall. Regards.
Well, there's a fake button right underneath that. Thanks a bunch, Keith Old.
I got nothing. I'm not sure why you asked me, but...
I've never even seen a couple.
Lemon, can you be Gene Wright?
Gene Wright, yes, absolutely, I can. A couple in Arizona sold their dog because the buyers wanted it for dinner. We called the cops, but they arrived too late. My cousin ran after the buyers, but they got away. We found out later the poor dog was sold to a hot dog vendor.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I believe it.
Yep.
Yeah, that's totally believable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So apparently there was like a dog drug deal that happened right in front of them where they ran after the buyers.
Yeah. The more I visualize it, the less I'm able to visualize it.
Yeah.
Frank West, you are the anonymous at the bottom.
I was going to say the last anonymous,
yes.
I bet.
Yep.
I'll tell you via email. After you have proven me, beyond any and all doubt, that you have already celebrated your 18th birthday.
Yay!
And your 18th birthday is bolded and underlined.
Yeah, also, so is after. This dude is serious. He doesn't really care if you're 18, but you have to have had celebrated your 18th birthday.
Right, yeah. We just kind of let it go by.
Oh, this person is anonymous, but they have a very lengthy profile on the site.
Sure.
And I'm just going to read a tiny blurb of it.
By all means.
I'm also a life member of the American Association for Nude Recreation, which is a group of around 50,000 nudists who simply enjoy fun things in the nude, because we, as a group, believe that if Almighty God had intended for human beings to be born naked all the time, we would... Naked, nude, tattoos.
Yeah. Naked, nude, Mensa, naked.
Oh!
Yeah, I saw Mensa as I was scrolling down. I was like, oh boy.
So, there is a lot of threads about penis enlargement.
Mm-hmm. Foreskin restoration?
Yeah.
You know, I didn't actually see any foreskin restoration in here, no, but I did see the penis enlargement. So we had to choose the best possible penis enlargement thread.
Well, blurt it, brother.
And by the best, I mean the best spelled. So, okay. Jimmy Franks, if you will ask the question posed in this thread.
Can I increase the size of my panic?
Sure, and, you can.
Anonymous there at the top. Jimmy Franks.
Oh, my pank size very small. I want to increase that. How I can increase, suggest me, and my sex time is very less also. I think this next one's from me, too.
No, this is a different person. Yeah. It's spelled differently.
Oh, okay.
So, Isfahan, you're the next anonymous.
I am.
You sure are.
Hi. I am just 20 years old, but my penis size is 5.2 inches. I won at 7 inches. How to make it? Please help me, thank you.
Oh, can I be anonymous?
Yep.
Good. All right. Yeah. Your penis is blood!
Deadly sinners! Deadly sinners!
I'd like to point out that is the first time the word penis has been spelled correctly.
Okay.
Welcome to the F+. Penis is blood.
Penis is blood! Increase the size of the blued vessels. Stretch the penis with your hand. Exercise to increase the blood flow and to increase the vein size. That's the basic way. Exercise and stretch.
Streck.
And right? Streck. A serve is the size of your palm. Each daily 3+ serve fruits, 3+ serve veggies, 3+ serve grains, 3+ serves proteins over meat. Please, 3+ serves calcium dairy.
Dent navel.
1 multivitamin a day. 1 cup of water every half hour. Other vitamins of your choice.
Wow.
6 to 8 meals a day. Exercise 1+ hour a day. Always warm up, then stretch before you do a session.
Are you having troubles with impotence? Consider obesity.
Yeah.
Weights or no weights is fine.
Sure.
YouTube right. Exercises.
The best.
Exercise every muscle in your body throughout the week. Start with the highest weight you can handle, then work down gradually a low weight through the session.
That's not how that works.
Do it until you can't. Don't stop for muscle pain. Muscle pain is good. Stop if you have bone pain.
Right. Okay.
As bone many reps, pain. As many sets, as little rest time as possible per exercise.
I'm feeling the burn! Take another weight off!
Mon cardio. 2's yep. upper body. Wed right. cardio. Right. Thrust a lower body. Fry cardio. Sat core. Sun your choice or rest.
Can I be the second to last anonymous?
My penis is cross. How straight?
My penis is cross. It's really ticked off, man.
Why have you not made me bigger yet?
And Anonymous helpfully provides take pills.
Just any pills. It doesn't matter.
This really does seem like the sort of topic who would bring out the absolute best answers. Oh,
the list of also asked ads.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, what else is in there?
How to increase my penis size.
You would think someone who's so preoccupied with their penis would know how to spell the word.
How well, I increase
why,
my
that's
penis
That's why Google's
size.
Failed them.
How to increase my pine size. How can I increase panish size?
You know what?
How can I increase my pennies?
You know what? I bet a lot of these are the same person. It's just like...
There are two others that are in... panic size.
Yeah.
Okay, so that was a very silly site, so we're going to do this one instead, much better. How can I improve my sex power?
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my client only wanted to improve his sex power.
How can I improve my sex power? You're the first anonymous, it's fun.
Make a paste of tea and tomatoes and use it on your penis at least 15 days regular.
Eat up, penis, I love you. Oh, penis isn't eating lately. He must be sad.
He's really getting thin.
Yeah. Just take it from me. You're going to want to wait for it to like reach room temperature. Don't just put it on right off the stove.
That will give a long stay power. Someone told me, and I tried it, really helps.
Boots, you are the anonymous that seems to want to talk about garlic a lot.
Oh, that's okay. You can improve your sex power by using garlic.
Sure, right.
Step right up, step right up.
Yep. Just take 3 pieces of garlic in the morning. Time for 1 month. But be careful, it causes side effect like mouth ulcer. Then take lemon juice, 2 in the noontime. And take
mouth ulcers, lemon juice is the last thing you want. You should rub salt in your wound.
Then take vitamin, minerals, capsules. Also, it can heal your sex power naturally. 1 month with lukewarm milk. And take fruits, too. Steal them.
Sure.
Yeah. You might get your hand cut off. Fruits are the best source of vitamins. Yeah. Yay, one more thing. If you're not able to chew garlic, you can buy Himalaya garlic pearls from chemist shop. Unnecessary asterisk. Garlic pearls is a medicine made from garlic juice. Both nonsense. Yeah. Packed in capsules. Good luck, friends.
Medicine.
The stupid kind of cancels it out, because that guy called it sex power, and this person, who is also stupid, knew exactly what it was talking about.
Oh, yeah, sex power.
Sex power. I know what that is.
When you're in bed one night, and you're the boy, but your feet on top of hers, and see if she reacts. If so, then put your hands on her boobs, and see if she reacts. Then, if she wants you to do something else more sexual, you are ready to have sex with her.
This post brought to you by the kid who sits next to you in sixth grade.
Sex power. Oh, my God. There's so many.
I like how there's hand / S. So if you happen to have a second hand, put that on her boobs, too.
Somebody should do Kiana Tate.
Frank West, take it.
You don't need to think about sex. You need to think about those books.
Tony Soprano?
Hey, Lemon.
Did Anonymous's mom come into this thread?
If you want to improve your sex power, then eat red dry fruit, like Anar, Chuck Nidder, and many more. And do an exercise daily. I'm 100% you improve your sex power. And wear red underwear.
Yes.
That's quite a punchline.
Sex power secrets they don't want you to know about.
Jimmy Franks,
Can anybody tell me what Chuck Nidder is supposed to be?
Chuck
or Anar?
Nope. It's dry red fruit, obviously. Yeah.
Okay. I think they mean Chikandar.
Hey, Jimmy Franks, what was this question also asked as?
Oh.
It's in the right column. It's the last thing in the right column. So this post, again, is how can I improve my sex power?
Well, many ways, Lemon. How could I improve my sex power? How can improve my sex power?
Right.
How you improve sex power? How I improve my sex power in time? How I can improve sex power? How to improve sex, period. How I improve my sex power? How I can improve my sex power?
How to improve my sex power and time? Not only is my sex power out of whack, my time is.
Oh, I'm sorry, I just had my sex period. Isfahan, what happens if you were to rip up a cardboard Ouija board?
You'd be out about $18.
Well, if the last time you played with the Ouija board, you conjured up any type of negative entity or didn't bring the cursor back to the word goodbye, when you were done playing with it, then you could be in trouble. First off, ripping up the Ouija board will not get rid of the negative entity if one was conjured out. Sometimes
it
only
still out on that. I feel like there's conflicting theories.
Sometimes it only makes it worse. So if that's E, or letter Y, you ripped it up, you're possessive SOL. If you didn't bring the cursor back to goodbye, and you did not bring in a negative entity, then whatever entity you did ask to play with you, and that board is not gone. Holy shit. But yeah. other than all that, ripping it up will not hurt you or anybody else.
Jimmy Franks, you have a different opinion. You're the next post down there, the next answer down.
Oh, I'm Ace Anonymous. You would have ripped up a cardboard pieces of a Ouija board.
MVP.
MVP. Yeah, I was thinking that.
Okay, which one of you guys wrote that?
If you make a mess, then you clean up the mess.
One of the related topics to this one, for some reason, is, do you love anyone?
10-month-old babies eat chicken nuggets?
Also, why are you taking custody of my 10-month-old baby?
That's fine, I'll just make another one.
Some of these answers are ridiculous. Mainly because from 6 months, a baby can have things like chicken, so why not chicken nuggets?
No, they shouldn't! No!
Or fish fingers.
Oh, God damn it!
I find it silly how some people constantly fret about what to feed their babies.
That is silly!
My son is
why are people worried about the nutrition of their children?
My son is 8 months old, nearly 9, and he will eat anything ranging from sandwiches cut up to mashed potatoes or beans. Fish fingers and chicken nuggets are his fave. He doesn't gag at all, and he's happy, healthy boy, the perfect weight. I feel by giving him a wide range of food that is paving the way for a balanced diet later in life.
Yeah, that's a good example of a balanced diet. Fish fingers.
No,
a
balanced
nuggets.
Diet later in life.
Yeah.
You know, first 10 years are all crap.
After they've been in the hospital.
We're going to wait till you get type 2 diabetes. Yeah. Then you're going to need a balanced diet.
I personally do not want a son who's fussing at the table or doesn't want to try new things. Would you jump off a cliff if someone said so or that it was the right way? No.
Just to be clear here, your way is the jumping off the cliff.
What I said.
That sounds dangerous.
Would you jump off a cliff, please? Would you?
I wish this person would jump off a fucking cliff.
So why do people ask what to give their kids?
Yep.
You're the mother, so you decide what he or she eats. Simple as. Not every baby is the same.
That's,
when it comes to nutrition, every baby is pretty much the same.
Frank West, you are Guanalawalan?
You try it. You're as good as any. I'm Guanalawan.
Guanalawalan.
I'm Guanalawan, and
I am Welsh.
My name's
Yes, as long as they are small pieces and the child has teeth. A lot of moms don't believe in it, but ask your child's doctor. My kids have been eating chicken nuggets since they were around 6 months old because they had teeth.
Teeth is not the indicator that your children are ready for solid foods.
They are continuously eating chicken nuggets.
It's a conveyor belt of chicken McNuggets.
And they are a healthy weight.
Someone please help. They will not stop eating the chicken.
Oh, there's a lot of comments. I don't want to read any of them. They make me sad. Let's go to a happier subject. Jimmy Franks, which of these two questions would you like to answer? I have two questions. They are similar, but not the same.
Okay.
So which would you rather answer? I am a werewolf, and I think my girlfriend is a vampire.
Stop right there.
Oh, come on. Let's.
All right. Let's hear the other one.
Okay, well, I didn't even get to the question part. I'm a werewolf. I think my girlfriend is a vampire. Am what I'm doing going against our nature? That's question number one.
Okay.
And the second question is, what are true facts about werewolves and vampires? Please don't say it's not real or any of that crap.
Ooh. Oh, man. Yeah, I should have waited. Oh, gosh.
Yeah, it's up to you, baby. Whatever you like.
Oh, man. If I can only choose one,
mm-hmm.
I still want to go with number one. I'm going to trust my gut.
Yeah. Right, yeah.
Terrific.
I'm feeling that one.
So, Jimmy Franks, this might be I don't know if this is a funny question or anything, but I'm a werewolf, and I think my girlfriend is a vampire. Am what I'm doing going against our nature?
I'm Pam Kruger.
There are 103 answers.
There are 103, yeah.
No, you're not destined to kill each other. No. Don't you right. know you can both still be friends, because friendship is stronger than going against nature. Kind of like love is stronger than hate.
I like how it's apparently understood that werewolves and vampires are natural enemies.
Well, a lot of what you have to understand is if you click on most of these responses, a lot of them think they are vampires or werewolves. They're answering from personal experience.
Yeah, they're experts. They're experts in the subject.
There's a vampire werewolf fairy in there.
Frank West, you're the first anonymous.
Oh, boy. Don't hate, appreciate, dude. I'm half and half werepire, and yes, any human reading this would put us in a mental hospital. We have to keep this on the down low, guys.
Half werepire!
Werepire.
So, when the moon is full, he turns into a burning bundle of sticks.
No, that's a different spelling of pyre. Come on.
Okay, I just assumed he misspelled pyre.
He misspelled everything else. It's not the greatest idea to put these kind of questions on the internet, but...
They can track you!
Wait, actually, no, I think that's just a really good motto for this website.
Yeah.
P.S. It worked with my parents. Like I said, I'm half and half. So yeah, if you don't hate each other, you should be okay.
When I was 4, my dad went out for blood and never came back. Half and half, wear apart.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Oh, my God. Okay. Yeah, Boots, take it.
Yeah. I'm a werewolf, and my best friend in the entire world is a vampire. We do not fight at all.
Right.
We have so much in common. We have del-cared ourselves, sisters.
Oh, that's nice.
But some of her vamp friends hate me.
Oh.
But we do not let anything bug us. It don't matter what species as long as you are friends. God, I hate it when people actually think that vampires and all werewolves hate each other. They don't.
Oh.
No.
Jimmy Franks, next anonymous down, please.
I'm a vampire werewolf fairy, and that's why I sparkle, and oh my gosh, it's so fun to dance through the woods and suck the blood out of all the little animals that come up to me, and then I catapult them through the trees and go hunt their corpses.
Sure.
Rip them to shreds, and flesh is so delicious and stringy hanging out of my mouth, and I have a boyfriend who's a vampire pixie merman, and he's so little and cute. We all go swimming all the time, and we suck the fish dry, and they die.
I like this poster.
All right. Boots, this is a little bit of a callback.
Okay.
Hey, this is in the food and drink section, healthy food specifically, in, I just had the most incredible raw food experience! Fresh chopped vegetables served in a bowl with dressing. Anyone know what this is called?
Oh, I can answer that question. I can answer it. My name is...
I want to be first in the phone book. It's a bail bonds company.
In my experience, such food is usually referred to as salad, and the dressing is called salad dressing.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. Sometimes a salad might have a special name. Example, a salad with a Caesar dressing is called a Caesar salad. A salad with apples and walnuts may be a Waldorf salad.
Maybe. It may be.
Don't be too quick to judge.
Yeah. Salads consisting of very large, chunky vegetables may be referred to as crudités. Vegetables chopped very finely and slathered in mayonnaise, or worse, salad cream, may be called coleslaw.
That's not what coleslaw is, but whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, I have a...
Oh, yeah.
Shit, where did it go? Oh, there it is. Yeah. So somebody is going to be Irshad Mirza.
I guess Jimmy Franks. Jimmy Franks, or Ersad Mersha.
Yes.
What is the importance of time in our life?
Time is the most precious thing in this world. Because time once past become your past. And past can never be back. Only those who value and respect it will reach the summit of success in their life. By Ersad Mersha, researcher.
Researcher of what?
The application of periods and exclamation marks.
Yes.
All right, so let's close out this episode with a longish list of actual blurted topics we did not get to tonight.
Wiki How style.
Let's start out with, let's see, let's go Isfahan first, please.
Okay.
Is there a Yu-Gi-Oh! Sex game?
How do we know what we know? My girlfriend has had sex with 6 different guys a total of 12 times, 4 of those times in bed and 8 times in cars. She said right. None of the times did the guys take her blouse off or touch her breast except maybe on the outside. Is she kidding me?
Yes, it's a joke.
Why isn't that, is she fucking kidding me?
I mean, come on. Is Chatterbait a safe website?
No. No, it isn't. I can tell you it is not. You'll find Mario fucking Yoshi there.
Well, now you know. Why do I not want to have sex with my boyfriend? Could it be I'm straight? What can I use in place of anal beads?
What can't you use?
Remote control.
How to ride a man sexually tutorial? How to get your boyfriend to have gay sex with you?
Come on! Let's have gay sex this time! Tired of us somehow having straight sex.
No straighty, no straighty.
How do we keep doing that, incidentally?
If you were straddling a guy sitting on a chair and his breathing gets really heavy, then after er done asks to go to the washroom, does that mean he most likely bursted?
Yeah, probably. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm a straight male, but I love to look at dicks. Is it normal?
To not know what words mean? Yeah.
Yeah. Can I drink a fat girl's urine?
Can I please? Please, can I?
Hang on. How fat?
Why do guys think girls can't give a good hand job? I've got something to prove.
I love you, blurt it. Frank West, what do you got?
I'm a Christian and I'm 15. I recently went online to look at women's body parts. Right. I didn't do for the same reason as porn, I just wanted to know how it all works. Even so, I was a little sexually excited, but I suppressed it. Have I sinned?
Yes, you lied. Yep. A lot.
Yeah.
That entire thing was a lie.
Yeah, it was a lie, yeah. Lemon nailed it.
What guy that doesn't want a kid has unprotected sex with a girl every time they have sex and never use protection?
Unprotected sex where they don't use protection? Damn.
Well, the first time it was in quotes.
Oh,
then
unprotected.
She had to define her terms.
These are not questions, most of them. That's
they
just
end with, they end with question marks.
Yeah. You're not paying attention,
not
Frank West.
That's a good question.
As it turned out, of the 4 Herman Cain accusers, 2 are porn stars, and a 3rd one is a longtime liberal political activist. He, typical liberal accusers. Especially the porn stars, do you think?
No, I don't. Not after that.
How skinny do pricks have to be?
Is there a standardization board that I can review with?
I want to make sure I fit.
I'm sick of all these fat cocks.
Do any of you girls out there find stripping and go-go dancing wrong? I find it sick that women who take their cloths off and dance for it with a pole for selfish men just for money, we're not sex robots, we're people. Who agrees with me?
Sex robot. Sex robot.
I'm a sex robot.
I feel like it's the poll that you're most offended by here.
Yeah.
Oh, Jimmy Franks, what do you got?
Oh, why do I like being a sissy who wears pretty panties?
Jimmy Franks curse check.
When a guy fingers a girl, isn't that the grossest smell ever?
This is a new Andrew Dice Clay routine.
Yeah.
Or a new Andy Rooney 60 Minutes bit. What will I need to inflate myself like Bambi Blaze does? Ever killed a housefly? There's a fly been hovering around me for hours, and it's getting annoying. Didn't want to ninja chop it. I'm not in the mood. Sure. Any normal ways of getting rid of the pest? Widows are open.
They sure are.
Widows are sluts.
That was in there just for that, wasn't it?
When is the next time I can have sex?
Baby, the internet says it's okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
As soon as you finish up, you just crank up the egg timer.
And you watch it like with your chin in your hands.
Which panties can men wear? How can make a person unconscious without using chloroform?
Because I looked into it. It's expensive. They ask you all these questions.
Well, technically dead people are unconscious, right?
They lack consciousness, yes.
Where can I find lonely, sexy women who like young men at?
Oh, dear.
Boy.
I think Jimmy Franks is about to end up on a database somewhere.
A database of young men who are willing to have sex with lonely, sexy women?
And have problems with participles?
Drink semen can increase height or not.
No, baby, I promise you'll be taller. You'll be taller.
Now, this one I have to ask twice, because I'm not really sure.
Yeah, you do.
There's no punctuation.
As many times as you need.
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to give a few reads.
All right, good.
What's up? My butt is sore a lot.
Okay.
Good.
What's up? My butt is sore a lot.
He keeps complaining while it's up there.
What's up? My butt is sore a lot?
I think that's my favorite one.
Hey, what's up? Are we going to be sucked into a black hole and all die tomorrow?
Is that a Hadron Collider
one?
My butt is sore a lot.
How do you know a girl is a virgin after having sex with her?
Truth isn't self-evident, is it?
No. No, a girl having sex and still being a virgin, that's what's going to cause us all to be sucked into a black hole and die tomorrow.
Oh, no, logical problem.
And finally, how do you know what a guy is thinking? Am I right, ladies?
No. Yeah. What a guy wants.
Ugh. Let's read things instead.
Okay, yeah. I forgot my PIN number. Can you help me?
Nope. Cannot.
What, no. Why are people being racist? Can you give me some examples?
Examples of why?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Is it legal to kill bacteria?
Genocide.
Yeah. I have a dull ache in my right side just below the rib cage. The ache radiates from the right front to the middle of my back, mostly at the right side. Sure. I've had upper and lower CAT scans and several chest rays that show nothing. What could it be?
I've been to a medical institution, so please diagnose me, Internet.
I don't know what this could be. Have you considered asking Blurtit?
Yeah.
How to increase fat with medicine. How can I improve my sex? I am 27, unmarried.
Oh, 27. I have no idea.
What do you believe to be a sin? How to get a boy hard on the phone?
Oh, I don't know. The only thing I can do on the phone is make a boy horny.
Yeah.
Could my dog be a racist?
I don't know. You'll have to give me some examples.
Why are dogs racist?
How do I tell my girlfriend I really am sorry after a fight? And when do I say sorry she says I didn't mean? How else can I show her I'm sorry?
That was a lot of Canadian sorries. I like that about that question.
Thanks. why do a fish has to lay so many eggs?
Yay, funny fish!
Why do a fish has to lay so many eggs?
He's just standing there at his fish tank. Fucking fish.
Stop laying eggs. Stop it. Oh, why does this have to happen? There's got to be a better way. What food do I serve with a sandwich tray?
Fish eggs?
Caviar.
How to make dog fat?
Okay, try one more reading of that, just in case.
How to make dog fat?
Maybe with dog fat.
Is that a recipe? Is that what they're looking for? Or?
How to get a very hard erection?
Like a difficult one?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And get an expert erection.
Yeah,
yeah. This one's in hardcore mode.
Yeah.
Erection Chivo!
Iron Man erection.
How do you know if you're a vampire? I have had a milky, creamy taste in my mouth for the past week. Any ideas what could be causing this?
Are you a baby? You should be eating chicken nuggets by now, really.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's been a nonstop stream of Cadbury's Easter cream eggs. They're going to go away soon.
All right, well, I got a couple more here. How to get white teeth overnight? Is the Luigi board real? There is more than one time that question has been asked and blurted.
People Luigi striking board. Out left and right on that.
Where are you, Mario?
Just there's on the Luigi board. There's an uh-oh.
Yeah. Anyway, can werewolves get food poisoning?
I don't understand. I thought being a werewolf was supposed to prevent this.
This is actually a question that's really fucking amazing. What does sex mean? I don't know.
Some people don't know.
I don't know. It's confusing. My dog ate some multigrain Cheerios with banana and milk and now has had diarrhea for days. I tried giving her some white rice from the Chinese food I ordered last night, and I think that made things worse. What should I do?
Feed her fucking dog food.
Just keep feeding her whatever food.
You mean chicken nuggets?
Yeah.
My baby and my dog eat out of the same bowl. This is a slightly shorter question than the previous one. Are gays okay?
Yeah, they're okay.
Yep.
Nothing great, but, you know.
Can you just check in on them? I mean, I want to make sure. I worry.
Hey, you guys doing all right?
All right. All right.
They're not awful, but they're not great either.
Hang in.
They're okay.
Can a person get MRSA by going to the funeral of a dead person who died of MRSA in the blood?
There's just aerosoled MRSA in the air at a dead person's funeral.
Depends on what you do with a funeral, I suppose. Also, the funeral of a dead person. Anyway.
Yeah.
It's Gigi Allen's funeral.
Well, yeah, you could get any kind of virus. Even 30 years after the fact, you could get MRSA from Gigi Allen. Is it okay for men to wear panties and Kotex maxi pads?
Just that brand, though.
Yeah.
Why can't an airplane stop in mid-flight? Why does white people's hair grow faster than black people's? Does anyone know how to stop bleeding?
Please answer right away.
This one's a puzzler. Do watermelons taste different?
Then what?
That tastes different.
They taste different than they used to. They've been changing them.
And finally, I want to be gay. What should I do?
A dude.
It's a good start.
Yep.
Oh, well, so we, you know, we visited several fonts of information. So, F+, I'm hoping you learned lots from this. What did you learn from Blurtit?
That vampires and werewolves can be friends.
Oh,
yeah.
That's like a nice message.
Ebony and Ivory.
I learned that vampires and werewolves cannot be friends.
One of the things I noticed from this is that,
Yahoo Answers is a place where, you know, somebody asks a question, and then there's a best answer from several pieces of criteria. And Blurtit said, best, I don't know. Let's get rid of that feature.
Yeah. That seems... let's be more egalitarian about this.
So it is one of those wonderful places where every opinion has equal weight, and everything is a fact. So I like that about it quite a bit. There's... How do so many of these sites exist?
I don't know.
Why does that happen?
Well...
Yeah, why? Oh, like one, sure. Okay, sure, there's one place where people say dumb things to the internet. Fine. There's so many of these.
Lemon,
I mean, it's good for the podcast, but what the fuck?
Lemon, Google's fucking hard.
Yeah.
Like, you want to do research, but you don't want to have to, like, you know, type words and then filter things out and be like, I don't know if that's the one. You just get somebody to answer it for you, and the first person who blurts out whatever the fuck is in their head.
Yeah,
but you still have to.
And like you know, and this saves you the aggravation of Yahoo Answers having this, you know, hierarchy of upvoted things. Like, people can have opinions on the other opinions. This way you just get like a blanket, just, you know, garbage mess of opinions thrown at you.
But
it's
you
delicious.
still have to to cycle through that stuff though, because like, you know, like you ask a question and for God knows why, you know, 40 people, I guess, you know, because they're, like, have as much time on their hands as you do. But, like, people ask, so you have to, I guess, decide on the opinion that you think is right. What's the social aspect of this? Like, are people just, like, meeting each other? Like, do people go, like, oh, yeah, you know,
I don't even know.
0010, she's a fucking smart lady.
Well, I don't even know the mentality.
These questions, they're like, has anyone seen so-and-so around?
Yeah, I don't even know the mentality necessary to, like, make use of these sites, like the question and answer sites, because some of these questions, somebody had to have that question, and then they had to retain that question long enough to sit down at the site and type it in. And there are other people who apparently just, like, hang out and answer questions as they come in. I don't understand.
While we've been recording this episode, I've clicked on probably, like, 30 different people's profiles. And every single one of them I clicked on, it shows you how many times they've answered, how many thanks they've had, how many followings they've had, and how many followers they've had. And every single time, thanks is zero, following zero, follower zero. There are social elements to this site that nobody uses. Nobody has ever used, apparently.
Well, I was going to say that would actually make a little bit of sense. It's like an incentivizing factor if, like, you know, you got thanked a bunch and all of a sudden it became... Because, you know, like, I was, for years, super-duper confused about, you know, as a web developer, I use Stack Overflow all the time. Where, like, I type a question, and then somebody on Stack Overflow has also asked my question, and then it has an answer, and that's terrific. But I don't understand the people that squat on Stack Overflow, like, waiting for PHP questions so that they can answer them.
Yeah.
Like, that's crazy. But, you know, that provides a helpful service. This, on the other hand, my dog is throwing up and shaking. What is wrong with him? Like, why are you asking that question? You're not going to get anything out of this. THEFPL.us, the website fucking where Russian spammers really just beat the shit out of us.
Yeah.
And you can complain about the word spastic being used. Otherwise, you can go to balp.it, and that's a good place. It's fun. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Night.
I accidentally touched a used condom.
Accidentally?
Yeah, I accidentally touched a used condom. I washed my hands immediately.
Sure.
That evening, hands touched my tongue without me even thinking about what occurred earlier.
Whose hands? Your hands?
Yeah, hands.
Just hands? hands touch my tongue.
Hands touch my tongue.
I live inside of evil dead.
Mm-hmm. What is the risk of my contracting HIV? It's transmitted through soap, right?
I think Asuka Jr. is too long to read the whole thing, but that first paragraph is awesome.
All right, take it.
Okay. The virus that is believed to be the cause of HIV and AIDS is highly vulnerable to oxygen.
No!
This is to say that if it is exposed to too much oxygen, it breaks down.
Wait, what? How would it exist in the world, then?
No, only if it's, like, too much. If it's just sitting in there...
That's
the table,
why
you, like,
people join the Mile High Club, because there's so much oxygen in the cabin.
That's why it transmits so well through blood, because there's no oxygen in blood.
Yeah. So if you have HIV, the way you kill it is to introduce a bunch of air bubbles into your veins, and it takes care of it. Get the oxygen in there.
I smell a sequel to Dallas Buyers Club here.